Good afternoon, everyone. Come on, man. Good afternoon, everyone. Lovely. You guys sound like you had some good lunches today. I know mid-semesters are on, but this afternoon, I trust that you guys are in well spirits because we are here to have a good time. Isn't that so? So let me do this formally. Good afternoon, everyone. And welcome to Mic Check 2023. Are you happy to be here? You're supposed to respond in the affirmative, yes. Are you happy to be here? Yes. The ultimate spoken word competition of the University of the Southern Caribbean is here. Today, we will listen keenly to some stirring literary pieces, thought-provoking poetry, and riveting words that were penned to perfection as 9 participants compete to be the Mic Check champion. So at this point in time, I would like to welcome you to our Mic Check competition 2023, and I do hope that as you listen to the pieces that you all would be inspired enough to become poets. Is that okay? Look at your neighbor. Tell them, neighbor, you might turn a poet. All right, good. I like the fact that some folks are laughing because it is your opportunity to showcase your ability to proclaim in whatever way, use your gifts and talents. So the participants, welcome. Thank you for accepting the invitation to showcase your skill set and understanding in the area of poetry even this afternoon. So with no further ado, allow me to invite each and every one of us to stand as we open with a word of prayer by Miss Leela Louis.
Let us all bow our heads as we pray. Our Father, we thank you for bringing each one of us here safely as we go into this Mic Check program, that whatever is being said here, we will understand it and we will take it into consideration. I pray that as the judges judge, that they will do their best and be impartial. In your name I pray. Amen.
Somebody say amen. All right. So, allow me to begin, rather continue, by just introducing you to our judges for this afternoon. Our judges are here in the form of and person of one, Mr. Hayden McKenna. He is a university writer and editor. You guys may have been able to do a few classes with him and know that he's an excellent individual with regards to his judgmental skills. So this afternoon, he's going to serve as our judge. Our second judge is none other than Mr. Vianney Tony, currently serving as the Associated Student Body President and also a student representative on the panel. Our final judge is in the form of the Dean of Men for the Noble Spartans of the Tim Grimsall, in the form of Dean Dominic Merritt. So give the judges a round of applause as they're here to guide in this activity. Now, allow me to share with you the criteria. So you guys have to pay attention to this here. One is that the judges are going to be judging the participants on one, message and content. You guys in the audience can sit and listen to the message of the pieces as well as the content. Two, delivery and performance, right? Its originality would be the third aspect, and also the overall impact. So whether or not the piece impacts you there in the audience, that is one key point. And finally, the judges are going to be paying attention to the participants' level of preparedness for their individual and respective pieces. At the end of the performances, the audience will have the opportunity. The audience will have the opportunity to vote for their favorite performer, and that participant will receive the People's Choice Award. So, participants and members of the audience, you all will be participating in today's program. So there is a People's Choice Award, and that is solely up to you. So get ready to choose who you see as the best performance. I will begin by again introducing the participants in the order of which they will be performing. One, you guys can give a round of applause when you hear the names. Show them some support. One, Zion Edwards. Two, Ashanti Prescott. Make some noise. Daniel Anthony is here performing for us, as well as Alfisha Gouchard. Our next performer will be one Cadence Grant. Make some noise for Cadence. Christian Bechu. Make some noise for Christian there. And finally, our final two participants will be Willon Ivan Nurse, aka Rocket. All right, so we see the folks are making some noise for Willon Ivan Nurse, as well as Gracie Samsundar and Joseph Trim. Make some noise for each and every one of the participants. They will be here showcasing their skill set. And with that, we will begin this afternoon's activity. Okay, lovely. That is an interesting and lovely question. Each participant has 5 minutes per piece. Okay? So 5 minutes each participant, yes? They said seven? Okay, between 5 to 7 minutes, right? So work between 5 to 7 minutes per piece. You guys do your best. Come well. The timer will be in the person of Miss Rihanna Belfon. So she will be keeping the time. So pay attention to the timer, because that is a key fact. And also, before I go, I'll allow for you guys to just give them another round of applause, give them some support, and enjoy the remainder of this afternoon's proceeding. So make some noise for our first participant, Ms. Zion Kelman, as she performs her piece.
Okay, well, my name is Anne Edwards, as you all know, and this piece is entitled Red. Red, a very flattering color. You know, this is also probably the first time in a long time that I thought about the color red without associating it with you. Red, fire, blood, anger, rage, passion, and you representing yourself in red. From the way you were easily hurt, to the deep red lines carved into your arms, to something as simple as your shirt, red always represented you. It represented you. Red always represented you. It represents you in my mind. So when I think of red, I think of you. Though ironically, you weren't more red than blue. Red, fiery, like the color of your hair, the way you would dance without a care, like no one was even there. Then you weren't so much red. You were orange, green, and blue, many other colors too, because to me, when you were happy, red didn't represent you. It didn't represent you. When you were happy, red didn't represent you. Red, like the color of our eyes when it was nice to sit up late, when you would laugh and relate. Now I look back and it's merely time, I can't compensate. I can't compensate. I look back and it's merely time, I can't compensate. Red. It was like what I felt for you when you made me more than just red. You made me blue, feeding me lies, convincing me it's true, muddling other colors so I would only see you. Red. Like flags and warning signs screaming no, and yet I still chose to go because red was all I could see. Until I was drenched in red, feeling as if the color of my woe defined me. Red, like the color of my anger, my rage, my pain, unforgettable lessons pulsating through my veins, memories engulfing my brain so I could never take happiness in vain, never take it in vain, never take anything in vain. Red. At first it was shallow, then I was drowning in that sea of red, pulling me down, bloody dread. I am soiled and coated in red. But red was never the color of us, nor was it the color of me, because mixing red with black never gave me red, it gave me burgundy. I am so glad I can say the color red never defined me. It never defined me. The color red never defined me. Red. There's so much I wish I could say, but whenever I see you, my lips betray. I still can't tell you all that I feel to this day. Red. My life was black and white until all I could see was red. But still, after you, I could see color. To keep myself sane, I tell myself it wasn't that bad. Though thinking of you still makes me a little sad, a little mad, a little red. Red. After all this time, I still don't have a clue. Sometimes I still get lost in thoughts of you. Was calling this love even true? To be honest, I don't know. I don't know. But sometimes uncertainty is all the closure we need instead of digging for empty answers until your hands begin to bleed. Red. No poem is long enough to sum you up, so at some point I should probably just, you know, stop. Red. Like an arrow in a bow, it's time to release that string. It's time to let the arrow go. Let the arrow go. Zion, let the arrow go. It's time for me to let you go. Thank you.
Make some noise, make some noise. Red, red. That was Zion Kelman performing for us. Red, loving it, we're loving it, we're loving it. So I'm sitting there and I believe that a lot of us here don't know what happens at the poetry show. If you guys hear something that relates to you, feel free to click a finger. So try it. Let's try that. Give it a click. Give it a click. Good. If it comes out and it really touches your soul, you could say a little ooh, ooh, yeah, hallelujah, praise God, something, you know. So free up. Support the participants. Our next participant will be Brother Ashanti Prescott. So make some noise for Brother Ashanti.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's a pity I'm wearing a red shirt. Must be that I'm red. Well, Good afternoon again. This piece is entitled A Tale About Cardiac Hill. It's for all of you out there, my brothers and sisters who live up there, Cardiac Hill with me. Way beyond the black suits and neat slick attire of excellence, the sheer sacrifice and staunch reverence. What thinkest thou, mediocrity? I'll tell you, Cardiac Hill ain't no drill. Express your will, I hear to he is a thrill. But boy, oh boy, that roller coaster pressure. To many a folks ain't no booster. But then again, get might be a deal for real. Once you can foot her bill. Cause inch by inch, she gonna wear you down. Pong by pong. I'm telling you, watch your pocket. Cause worries, man. Up there, the wildlife them plenty full. Forget them teaspoonful prescription is large spoonful. No worries, mate. No need to regurgitate. But anticipate, cause the end go be great. Just you wait, for soon you'll validate. For small beginnings are the hallmarks of glorious endings. Surely you can relate. Just keep those eyes fixed upon the appointed date as you navigate. But boy, to the agouti thing and the rat attack, leptospirosis might be your fate. Secure your plate, your vegan steak, and delicate chocolate. But even this, some care relate, because for them is a habitual mistake. Much less the double-headed snake. Trini is also called the legless lizard. Great. I really don't mean to exacerbate, but even more bizarre, a multitudinous array of bugs from the flyer flies at Timor Free Gives Hall, who wow butterflies in the females next door. Don't talk about invitation and maybe manipulation, but fraternization, because a lush green mixture of flowering plants, like a whole forest, short, tall, slim, full figured, Coca-Cola, ooh la la. Them young men watching, eyeing them like it's doubles, scrumptious doubles. It's plenty different flavors. Mild, spicy, fiery, ting and ting. With lovely symphonies, just wanting to be heard. Yet in the background, many at times, ascending blended rhythm, like the USC String Orchestra. Or even the drum band unleashing their unique brand. They too want to be heard amid the constant echoes of moving traffic, chirping, barking, chatting, and laughing, talking. Cardiac Hill, seemingly very prolific. Thank you.
Make some noise, make some noise there as we make way for our next contestant, Daniel Anthony. I don't know about you guys, but I was there and I was laughing, thinking to myself, hey, doubles and all the different flavors. Let me see if you guys like the sauce doubles. Yeah, the next sauce? All right, give me, which one you like? Call some doubles name. Let me hear some doubles. Raffinas. Next one. Let me know the one champ. Next double stand. The one in Q rep. That's the best one. Good. So I would like to think that the judges are ready for us. Before they begin and Danielle comes, let me just make a brief announcement for you guys. And that is on ASB elections. The elections will be held on Thursday, April the 13th, 2023. Polls will be open from 7:30 a.m. and they close at 7:30 p.m. Each and every one of you, students of the University of the Southern Caribbean, you required, encouraged to participate in this event because you will determine who runs and governs and represents you as students, okay? All are encouraged to get involved in ASB. Let me tell you this quickly. Nominations are invited from students across our campuses to nominate a candidate, and the forms are accessible. You guys can take this information. It will be accessible at usc.edu.tt/voteASB. I will give you some ongoing information on that. So take note, usc.edu.tt/vote, which is VOTEASB. Let's make way for Daniel Anthony as he gives his performance.
Before I give my performance, could the media team just upload my topics on the screen so everyone will see? Because I'm basically just going to have a discussion with you all before we start timer. Could the media team please put my stuff on the screen? All right. Okay. So my piece today is human objects. So as you can see here, these will be the topics that I'll be discussing with you all. I would not be calling them out one by one because of time. However, the question I have to ask you is, how much of these topics relate to you all? How much people do you know are currently facing any of these topics that I have here? So I just want to say this, right? Because many of us are being used by our society in so many different ways. We are like pawns within our homes, our society, the government, our institutions, you name it, right? But what can we do to stand up for ourselves? How could we not make ourselves objects, but how could we learn to be independent for ourselves? Look at how many homes that are being bashed and damaged due to the fact that many fathers are just walking out of the households. Women being forced into being sex tools, maids, forced marriages, and all of these different things. Bargaining chips within the relationships where divorce happens and child custody goes sometimes to the abusive parent just because one parent earns more or because they have certain leverages. And many a times the child is not heard, right? And what happens is that when the child goes into that household, they might be mistreated, abused, all because that parent just rather wants the money from the child support, or they just want to dominate control over the other parents. They don't really care about the child. But, I mean, children are our future, right? We are the ones to bring about the brighter future, right? So I'd like the team to scroll down a little bit to my quotes that I have here. So some of these things, right? I'm quoting from the book Spear by Prince Harry. And this is literally how Prince Harry felt after he lost his mother, the one who he was closest to. Pa said mommy hurt her head, but perhaps I was the one with brain damage. As a defense mechanism, most likely my memory was no longer recording things as I once did. This is the way how us children within society feel whenever we are not being heard, when our voices are going unanswered. So I am just here to say that we should be using our social platforms to uphold one another. I mean, there are many people who are afraid to speak out, whether because they are afraid that if they do speak out, they will be sued for defamation of character, they might face legal issues, or they might be shut down. But we should be holding each other up. We should be telling our stories. You never know that when we tell our stories, how it might be impactful on somebody else. No matter what we face in life, we should never give up. Because, I mean, what motivation could we give someone if we were to give up, right? Look at the sun, the stars, the moon. The sun is the brighter light. So let's put the sun as our mentor. The moon would be us. We shine the light from the sun onto the earth. The earth is our audience, the people who I am motivating. The stars will be like those who are also enhancing our light, so those working under us. And I mean, we should be supporting one another. So as I close, I will be just saying this line from Prince Harry: "Come on, come on, you're free, fly away." And then against all odds, all expectations, that wonderful, magical little creature bestirred itself and did just that. And my closing line: "Why don't the objects reject their manipulators and project themselves into the subjects of their lives, creating a brighter future for our nation?" That's all for today.
All right. Make some noise. Show some support. Thank you again for that piece. See, when it's nice, you do it twice. But we press for time, so we can't lime. Okay, so our next participant will be in the form of Miss Alfisa Bouchard. Make some noise, yes. She's gonna keep my company here while I make some continue with some announcements. Yeah, so to continue with our announcements, nomination closes Thursday, which is this Thursday, March the 2nd at 11:59. So you guys are still in time to make your nominations. Candidates must be at least in their second year of university, must be registered and have a regular admission status. They must have a cumulative GPA of no less than 3.0, and in good citizenship standing. And remember, for all things, follow the campaign trail at usc.edu/vote-ASB. So make some noise for Miss Alfisa Bouchard as she brings and gives us her piece.
This piece is entitled "Different Phases in Different Stages." Bowing down on my knees, God, I'm begging you to help me, 'cause I am nobody. Tell me, what do you see when you look at me? You have a gorgeous smile. I have a nice smile. What if behind my smile I'm dying inside and my anxiety is the only one that I could confide in? Because fear, pain, and tension and exhaustion has taken over my domain, and nothing else remains apart from being lonely and sad all the time. And at this stage, in this phase, I try to hide because they can't know. I can't let it show. I just have to upload that thin line, put back on my mask, and smile. I'll be fine. Everything will be okay. I will get through today. I say, everything will be okay. I will get through another day. I can't let them see. Don't let them see. Don't let them see how I judge me. Because when everybody whispers and has so much to see, my flaws, failures, and mistakes are on a direct replay. I'm trying to escape cultivated circumstances that constantly convey corrupt criticisms in my mind. My conscience is callous, but I can get through this. I said, my conscience is callous, but I can get through this. That's what I say to myself, because at this stage, in this phase, when I look in the mirror and the reflection that I see isn't me, what I see is that I am nobody. Nobody just trying to get through another day. Nobody that her whole life she wanted to take away. Nobody that away from God she strayed. Nobody that in her own persona no longer wanted to stay. Living and prioritizing, it seemed a bit cliche. Black and blue lines vanished. The only thing that I saw was gray. Caged in a cell, chained down by depression, a searching but can't seem to find the momentum, poisoned by the consequences of sin's venom, arrived at a destination where I become numb, enslaved in my body and can't seem to find freedom. So where do I go from here? Because at this stage, in this phase, I'm now moving backwards. I take one step forward and a million steps back. I can't seem to stay on the right track. I'm losing friends like money because I can't stay loyal to nobody. I'm struggling to even love me. Everything that I'd become, I didn't even want to be. So I'm hurting others while I hurt it. I'm hurting others while I hurt it. Overwhelmed and frustrated. I gasping for breath, but I just keep drowning. And my thoughts just above me floated. Is there a legitimate reason to compensate for the inconvenience that I caused? Closed in by these walls, consumed by the hunger of my own guilt. And all these secrets, they just make me sick. Because at this stage, in this phase, the tears no longer want to flow. For all these sleepless nights and wet pillows, I can't seem to have any more left. There are invisible tattooed teardrops from all my casualties, simultaneous effects of failed strategies. Battle scars embedded in my skin from the wars that I've fought. No matter how I try to win, I just keep losing. Alive but feeling like I'm existing without living. My eyes open but I'm not seeing the right path to choose. And at this stage, in this phase, it now feels like I'm dreaming. Because when you left me, mommy, I was detached from my being. I'm fighting to conceptualize, but I can't seem to analyze what is happening. All I feel is this emptiness inside, just enough space for pain and confusion to reside. God, why? And there began the downfall of losing myself. Self-worth and happiness was now placed on a shelf. I just acting without caring, just assuming without praying. It's like I'm following a broken compass because my direction had rail off and I just lost. At this point, the negative circumstances seem to be on a systematic uproar. From one thing to the next, it's like I've lost control of my mind. My soul step aside, and at this time, all you're seeing is a frame. Is it a game? It's not a game. Get me out of this nightmare. It's not a game. Get me out of this nightmare. Because at this stage, at this phase, I'm separated from reality. This can be. Someone help me comprehend why he touched me, violated every aspect of my body, and clean, they took advantage, and at this point I can't manage because it's too much. My rock bottom, not hitting rock bottom. I just keep going downwards. I refuse to believe that this is the end for me. And it was at this stage, through this phase, that my God stepped in. He said, chin up, princess, you're the daughter of a king. I know it has been tough, but you are enough. Just exercise patience, for patience work at experience and experience hope, and even when you're feeling like you can't cope, tap into the Holy Ghost and just overdose in His word. See, when I allowed God's Spirit to permeate my excuses, the devil could no longer reciprocate my feelings, because when Christ entered there, began the moment of healing. He already forgave me 70 times 7. He can transform nobody to somebody. With Him, I already won. God help me to tap into my divinity, so when humanity tells me that I am less, now I don't stress. Because God plucked me from obscurity and set me free from my insecurities. What you now see is a mere speck of my beauty. You need to remember that I am royalty. Forget about my past. God has given me a new identity. I'm now walking with dignity. Because at this stage, in this phase, on this stage, I speak with integrity.
You guys enjoyed that piece there? At this stage, at this phase. Make some noise again for Miss Bouchard. You guys are privileged. Let me tell you, you guys are privileged enough to see the talent that is here at USC. I bet you didn't know that these young people were so talented. You're here and you're getting all of this for free. For free. Normally you gotta pay how much, like $330 to probably get into a show like this. But you guys are having it free here. Our judges are compiling the scores, and in the meantime, we're gonna make way for Miss Cadence Grant. So she's gonna prepare herself, make some noise for her. After Cadence Grant, I was encouraged to give you guys a piece of poetry. You guys wanna hear a piece of poetry from me? Huh? You guys want to hear it now? Where's Cadence? You ready? All right, good. Cadence says she's not ready. So judges, you let me know when you guys ready. All right. Let me see how I do this. You guys ready? Roses are red. Cliche, y'all don't want to hear that one? All right, good. I have a next one then. Flips page. Do you know what it feels like to enter someone's inbox? You scroll up, you pause. You scroll down, and you pause. And then you end up exiting that inbox? But wait, only to pause and enter that same inbox again. You gaze at it, hoping to get a text message. So you scroll up, you pause, you scroll down. You start typing the words, hi, backspace. I miss you, backspace. What's wrong? Is everything okay? You pause and then decide to click and send it. And then decide to click that send option, but you just exit. That's been me for the past few minutes. I mean days. I feel like a backspace, not like the delete button only, but it's just that I'm at the back taking up space of your heart and bringing last in the race. But why is there even a race, a competition for your heart, when I was the only one at the start line? Is what I've been writing day after day and moment after moment, time after time, but I guess it's just me. The one with the feelings. Yes. The one who now has to get some form of therapeutic healing. All I'm trying to say is that I've been thinking about you a lot, hoping that one day I fit in any available space in your heart, even if it's a little slot. I love you, Backspace. Thank you very much. Let's make way for Cadence Grant. Cadence Grant, dear.
Hi everyone, my name is Cadence Grant and the poem is entitled Overwhelming Pain. Life is full of pain and we have nothing to gain or retain, only sadness. So here I am, talking about pain as if it doesn't evidently shape our future selves, but here I go. 10 things to know about pain. Rule number one, pain lasts forever and ends never, because it does something like tether to the heart. Number two, don't ignore the pain because it will follow you or creep up on you until you can no longer run from it. Three, feel the pain or you'll be forced to emotionally kneel to the pain, and that isn't what you want to succumb to. Four, keep the door to your heart closed or pain is all you will feel. Five, dive in the waters of peace before it's too late. Six, don't let your emotions mix. Seven, pretend your way to happiness. 8, people are unreliable, don't wait. 9, remember the divine fact that you were born alone and you die alone, so just be alone. And 10, they say pain is temporary, but what's so temporary about this involuntary pain that violently intrudes my life? I feel like it's going on forever. They say it will be over, it will get better. It always does, but does it? That's my million-dollar question for you. Is this pain temporary, or is it that you think of it as pain temporarily till you get kind of numb to it? The tears become a waste of valuable time, but time isn't that valuable anymore when you feel so sad all the time. Many may say I'm exaggerating, overreacting, or acting like it's overwhelming, but it is. Or it can be so hard, but you can't see my pain because it's my pain. It's meant to be painful for me. But what's painful for you? Do you sit in your room sometimes as your tears fall, you feel like it's never going to stop walking, running, dripping down your plumped red cheeks as your once white eyes turn the shade of the blood that's coursing through your warm skin slowly? But surely the tears begin to end, it's stopping, until someone asks a question, are you okay? How can such an innocent question stir up so much feelings all at once? Deceitfulness, sadness, the absence of happiness, I cannot. I cannot bear to answer that question, feeling the way I feel, but how I feel is how I feel. I cannot bear to answer that question the way you want me to. You want me to say I'm happy, but I'm not. They say the remedy to pain is to smile. Smile through it all. Even if you pretend, eventually you'll fool yourself too. And I try smiling. See? I'm trying, but it's not working. Because my smile is fake. The joy in my voice is a figure of not only mine, but your imagination. Because you hear the sadness in my voice. And this is not something meant to be depressing, but it feels suppressing because I cannot express my distress in a way that would impress the oppressed. No one must know how I feel. No one must know how I practice my faces in the mirror, my happy face, which seems to have become a shapeshifter when midday begins, my excited face, which is a cover for all the anger coursing through my veins, my resting face, which apparently must give the impression that I want to talk when walk away is all I want to tell most people. The mirror is my guide. Each morning before the world sees me, no one must know that I have been sad or angry. They must know that I have experience with pain. According to them, I don't even know that name. They mustn't know my pillowcase is filled with tears and my covers are soaked with feelings of sadness, but they mustn't know the reason I have more than one carton of ice cream in the freezer for times I cannot explain, the sleepless nights when the silence is too loud for my seemingly sensitive ears. They mustn't know the reason I have napkins or wipes or why I tilt my head back as to stop the tears from falling too far. Let's just say that I'm always prepared. I'm always ready in case I break down when the pain becomes too much to bear. They think I'm weak. You think I'm weak. Now I get it. Why they say fake it till you make it. I'm okay. I'm okay. I'm okay. I'm okay. I'm okay. And if I'm not, I will be okay. And you will be okay. And I can say that with the fullest of confidence because God is in control. My God, your God, the God we serve is in control of my life and your life and the life of those who aim to persecute you and the problems that aim to keep you down and out. But let me bring out the astute observation from you that God has a plan. He had a plan and continues to plan our lives. Everything happens for a reason is what they all say, and that reason is God. Who are you to try to detect or inspect how God is trying to direct? Who are you to not believe that you will be fine? It's about time that you realize all God can do, will do, and has done for you. I'm not saying to smile and be happy all the time. I'm saying to find comfort, knowing that after all that struggle, all that pain, all those tests that shaped your future testimony will be for a reason. I will be okay and you will be okay too. From the top of your head to the sole of your feet, you will be okay. From heartache to headache, I'd be okay. Despite the pain and sadness, disdain and pleasure, we will all be okay. Learn to be okay. So please, keep trying to be okay. Thank you.
Make some noise there for that lovely rendition. That piece was nice. I really enjoyed it. I was sitting there, I'm like, and I was then like, and then it ended up like, and then I was like, and I was like, so that was good, that was good. Make some noise again for Cadence Grant. Coming to us next is a very special individual. I had the opportunity to meet this young man right here this afternoon before we came up here this afternoon. His name is Christian. He continues to tell me and correct me on his surname. And he says it's not the short vowel sound, but the long. And it's B, B, Bish, Bishu. Right? So make some noise for Christian Beshu as he performs for us this afternoon. Come on, man. You guys got to make some more noise than that, man. Make him feel welcome. Yeah.
Good day, everybody. Finding people to talk to these days has been hard and honestly a bit like hell. But even when it comes to talking, if you want something done right, you do it yourself. And I know how hard it's been, but before you talk to yourself, right before you talk to yourself, talk to me, the insanity salesman. Tired of talking to everybody else and maintaining relationships with dreary, drawn-out dialogues. Those dreary, drawn-out dialogues that seem to shatter your shoulders, is carrying that cast of common conversation also feeling like boulders, a Sisyphean task. Well, if you're like me, and you think you're above these skull emojis and greetings, and tired of talking to everybody else, talk to yourself a little bit. As the ambassador of everything intrapersonal, trust me when I say it better than any narcotic. Because it's easier to use, it's free, and it's only slightly psychotic. And after all, why do you need friends to give you advice, to give their counsel dominion in your life, when you could just get the dominion from yourself, get the advice from yourself? Would you rather have the expert's opinion? After all, can you think of anybody better than you? Aren't you the standard you hold everybody else to? What you want everybody else to be? But pretending I like my own company that much is false, a fib, a fantasy. You see, the role in my peers' lives has always been a bit more fatherly. Ever since I was young, I was told I had an old soul and that stoicism made people reverent of me. And to be thought about as set apart is nice, but it's not really all that great because it tends to make people think you're above them when you just want to be their friend. And it seems like I was always the one who was level-headed, acted logically, and avoided altercation, when in reality, I was just shy and feigning maturation. It seems like where I want to be and where I am are in entirely separate universes, or should I say dimensions, because it feels like I have two-dimensional solutions for three-dimensional curses. Like I'm wasting my time in the sphere of my issues writing poems with circular verses. And that could never be a good thing, because circular verses leads to cyclical thinking. But that won't even be the worst thing that goes on in this head. And I mean, I would never sell my soul, but could I at least trade the old one for a young one instead? Because you think I'd appreciate the old soul's wisdom, especially in the life so far that I've led. But the thing about being old is that all your friends are dead.
I don't think you guys got that one. You guys got that one?
Yes.
The thing about being old,
yes,
is that most of your friends are dead? Or all? All your friends. Wow. I mean, that was deep. That indeed was good. That was a good piece. The insanity sink salesman. Make some noise again for Christian. These guys have been showcasing their talents very well. You guys want to hear next poem? Once is good enough. Our next participant hails from the beautiful island of Tobago. He's known on the dormitory as Rocket. Some call him the Rocket Launcher. And he's here to showcase his piece to each and every one of you this afternoon. So, USC, make some noise for Mr. Willen Ivan Norris as he presents for us this afternoon. Okay, so the judges told me they need some time, so I'll give you another piece, right? Short poem. Let me see. I gotta look for this one. Let me see. Another one. Oh, I get one. Good. Roses are red. Serious? I gotta skip all my roses are red poems? All right, good, good. Next one. Okay, poem. This one is titled Loading, right? Look at your pardon. Look at somebody next to you and tell them loading. Loading, right? It's loading. So it starts like this. Waiting for a connection. Reconnecting. Poor connection. Hey, I have something to tell you. The device freezes and my words flow like a river to express my feelings and tell you that I love you forever, but you hear nothing. And I'll have to repeat. And it appears to be a case where my heart has been on repeat for your love, expecting a love that is like no other, scared to allow itself to be loved by another. Poor connection is what I've been experiencing every time we meet. And every time we talk, it appears to be a case where things are not the best. But I know this, that even though the call ends, my love for you will never end. Maybe there will be some poor connections, and I pray that from today, there will be a pure connection. Maybe one delay, lagging, but never will I allow it to end. You're my favorite person. You're my one and only friend. The talk time we have will never be enough. So I'll always make time for us. You're the best, and I won't let it rest, because even though the call drops, I'll be there, ready to pick you up whenever you call again. P.S. I love you. That's it. So make some noise for Mr. Willen Ivan Norris as he gives us his piece.
Yo. I am nervous. But anyway, let me go this. Let me do this. Watch happen. Before I start here, just blast me off. Let's count now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Boosh. My piece is called Dear Arms Hope. Dear Arms Hope. Dear Arm Hopes. It's me, the rocket. Do you want to feel me? Do you want to touch me? Can I hold you in my arms again? Can I hold you in my arms again? Can I touch you? Can I touch you? Can I feel you? Can I feel you again? I'm here. Dear Arm Hopes, it is me here waiting, hoping, coping. But now all I feel is pain, pain, pain. When I saw you and him walking in the rain, oh gosh. Do you remember how it feels to touch? Do you remember how it feels to touch? Do you remember how it feels to touch? My body. And your body was my body, and my body was your body, and my body was your body, and your body was my body, and my body was your body, and we're all bodies. And now your arms. I'm my biggest enemy. And all I see is bodies and bodies and bodies. And I see bodies, 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 bodies. And bodies filling up this earth. And oh, Mother Earth is crying. Oh my gosh, Mother Earth is crying. She's crying. She's crying. Because your arms can't use your hands to touch and to dry the tears. Because you know what? Your arms are arms of massive destruction. And I only hope that history don't repeat itself. Because history always repeats itself. Dear arms hope. Arms hope. Dear arms hope. Oh gosh. Hello. 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 Hello, hello, arms up, hello, arms up. It's me, Rocket. It is history repeating itself. And before 1914, there was 100 years of wars and 100 years of peace. And war and peace again and war and then peace. That's confusing. Like you have to blast me off because I don't understand this. This peace, because this peace is not my peace, and my peace is not your peace, and peace is not peace, and peace, and we all have pieces. The arms hope, because it was militarism, alliances, imperialism, nationality that helped contribute to the First World War. And it contributed to the First World War and didn't just shot Archduke Ferdinand. The arms hope. You know, Siberia and all these countries in the European, they needed their freedom. And now look at me in my sweet TNT, my TNT, my TNT, red, black, and white, red, black, and white. That's who is me, Rocket. My TNT, everybody are arms trigger happy, arms trigger happy. And they don't really use the arms anymore for hugging. But their arms sugar happy. Extra, extra, read all about it. They have just shot one. They have just shot one. They have just shot one family. They have just shot one family. And how do you kill the dreams that Dr. King have given me? I have a dream that one day you and I, Arms Hope, will have that peace. Not this peace, but that peace. Do you know what is hope? Hope is an optimistic state of mind. Do you know what is hope? Hope is based on an expectation of positive outcome. It with respect to events and circumstance in one life or the world at large. It's a verb and it's divine and include expectation and confidence. And you know what? It cherish a desire of anticipation. And now I live the nightmare that haunts me. Dear Arms Hope, please, please, please don't lose that hope in me. And as I die. I only hope that peace that I have is eternal life, that peace within you and me. I'm soup.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Dear Arms Hope, you guys heard it live and direct. I'm telling you guys, you can't pay for stuff like this. You can't pay. You got it? You guys got it? You paid? All right, so as we prepare for our next participant, we're almost through with our program this afternoon. Give the participants that went before a round of applause. We're here supporting them. In time, I was told to share another quick short poem. I don't know. You guys, this is just for time. This one is called, this one doesn't have a name, but we're just going to anticipate our next participant, Miss, good. So she's here. Let me get your name. Our name is Miss Gracie Samsundar. She'll be bringing our next piece for us this afternoon. So make some noise for Miss Gracie as she delivers her piece. In the interest of time, I'll give you a short poem and immediately after me, Miss Grace is going to bless each and every one of you guys. So this one doesn't have a name. This one is for persons who normally don't sleep well after probably a heartbreak or anxiety or something. I don't know. Yeah, that's just the essence. It says, deprived for sleep. Deprived of sleep for words that will soon be forgotten. Crying tears that will never be seen. Emptiness is somehow filling a void that is there. And so life is filled with emptiness. Filled with nothing. On earth are the traits that are not spoken but expressed. All but in vain. Challenging will be the thought of knowing me. Calls always allowed to end but never ended. Connections made stronger than Wi-Fi pods used for ongoing configurations. The brain networks your love, configured to make our connection stronger. Stronger is your love when intentions are pure. Gossip will never ruin. Envy will never end. The love that we give each other because it is endless. Make some noise for Miss Gracie Samsundar as she gives her peace. Good.
Just waiting 1 second. This piece is called Fear. A father cannot compare to fear, but when you switch, That is when the fear kicks in. A father cannot compare to fear, but it's right there. You can't spell father without fear, because when the TH is silent and you flip the EA, it's violence. You dread the nights when you're asleep. When you hear the floors creak, you know you're in deep. Like the wounds you gave to me, no, us, I should say, because Monopoly is not a two-man game. The candy you shared was not sweet, but more mental pain came into play. I'm sorry does not matter. When trauma takes over, it leads into a ladder up in my mind where there's no limit to pain, like a lily blooming in the mud. Deeps run root beneath the darkness. Roots run deep beneath the darkness, but above there's a smile on my face that says I'm okay. But I keep God close to my heart because he said, what you sow is what you shall reap. So I know he will do his part. But if a new car is an apology, I don't need to hear I'm sorry. I have no fear nor doubt in my mind that God will deal with you over time. For a father protects his children, not letting anything slide. Just remember, karma is a sweet demise.
Loving it, we loving it. Fear. Oh, it went. Can't spell father without fear. Because when you flip it backwards, is what? Problems. So violence is not problems? Yeah, come on. Violence. Our final contestant, we winding down. Our final contestant, participant for this afternoon is none other than Mr. Joseph Trim. Make some noise for Joseph Trim. By way of announcement, before Mr. Trim comes on, this is just a PSA. Dr. Chan is reminding all social science students of a meeting on Wednesday at 3:05 on Zoom. The link will be accessed from the secretary's extension, which is 2601. So for all social science students, feel free to contact the school and get through the extension to the secretary via 2601, because Dr. Chan has a class with you. Make some noise once more for our final participant, Mr. Joseph Trim, as he gives us our final piece for today.
First, good afternoon, everyone. Once again, my name is Joseph Trim, and I will be performing a piece I wrote entitled Daydreamer. I want some answers. Tell me why I should forever suffer alone. Sure, I have a place to call home, but not really. Sure, I have friends and family. They consist of my echo, my shadow, and, well, me. Yes, the three stooges all together in one. Ladies, this could all be yours for the low price of loyalty and honesty. But that's not realistic, is it? You see, I've realized that nobody loves anybody, and everybody is willing to keep up the charade. Everybody, each and everyone, is an actor without pay. Each and everyone that keeps up the charade, regardless of their beliefs or reasons, day after day, is my enemy. So it's me versus the world. me versus anything that should harm me. But if I don't feel pain, then I have not been harmed. If I continue to aim at my goal, never taking it out of sight, I have no need for alarm. So call me the daydreamer, the one that never awakens to the accepted lies in an unacceptable world. One where gold holds more weight than God. One where everyone from Pope to vagrants are frauds. One that would stifle my purity so that I may join the everlasting charade of love. The truth is, those that understand love are few and far between. No, I am not the kind of man thirsty and hungry to get between, even if the thing fat or clean. You see, that don't faze me. Sex is too accessible to make it a main goal. It's more like a side mission. My goal consists of multiple cars, a decent yard, and a nice woman. You see, the kind of woman I could put my head on a block for, never thinking twice when I walk out the door, because when I walk back in, my house is already the home I dreamed of, and I find my everlasting peace. Thank you.
Make some noise again for that piece there, by bro. Some noise for all the participants that would have done this stuff today. You guys came out and would have been previewed to USC Mic Check 2023. When I say Mic Check, you say USC Mic Check.
USC.
Mic Check. And when I say 20, you say 23. 20?
20.
The best, they say, is yet to come. It's not over until the fat lady sings. So guess what? It won't be over today because we don't have a fat lady to sing. However, I'll allow Mr. Kalen Roach to make his way here, where he will conclude this afternoon's program. I would like to thank you for being here. My name is Jamal Pompey, and it was lovely being your host for this afternoon. Have you laid the scores for each participant? You guys can sit and be scintillated by whatever else is to come. Thank you once more.
Good afternoon, everyone. So for this segment, no, I'm just waiting till the QR code is on the screen. We are going to our People's Choice Award. So now this is the time we're going to take out your phones. And the QR code is there. You have about 5 minutes to vote. Oh, it's too bright. Tech. Yeah. Anyways, I'm just going to call out the contestants one by one. So we have Zion. And when I announce, just give them a round of applause. So we have Zion. We have Daniel. We have Ashanti. We have Christian. We have Alfisha. We have Cadence. We have Willen Ivan Nurse. And we have Joseph. Did I forget anyone? Guys, you have about 5 minutes to vote. It not scanning? Yeah, just turn around. Yeah. Anyways, while you select your vote for the People's Choice Award, I'm just going to do some announcements. So on March 16th, we have our Olympiad. Now, this is our sports day. Now, we'll be battling school versus school at the Larry Gomes Stadium in Arima. Now, coming up this week. Continuing, so on Wednesday, we have our tug of war and maxi taxi race coming up. So now for our tug of war, we need 8 persons from each school. So send your best representative and no less than 3 females on that team. And for our Maxi Taxi race, we need 5 persons from each school and no less than 2 females. And this is all commencing on Wednesday, and we have our finals next week. Now, these South students will also be showing up, and they'll be looking to win. So schools, come up with your best people. Is the code working? And the time is ticking. We have 2 more announcements. So now on Sunday coming up, we have our 6K fun run sponsored by the SPED and the school's 95th anniversary department. Now this fun run will be starting from St. Augustine to USC. Now this is $25 for students and $95 for everyone else. So you can register on our USC page, usct.95 or 6K run.
Just a quick announcement here. All students who are interested in canvassing within the Caribbean Union territory, but also in Canada, CYC, challenge. We have a meeting Wednesday in LH14. You don't want to miss that. If you are interested, if you are eligible as well, that means you are a non-gate student, you are a registered student, you have a good citizenship records, meaning you have not, if you are a resident hall student, you have not been breaking curfews on a regular basis. You haven't been giving the dean, you know, any kind of challenges as such. You know what I'm saying? So you've been behaving well. You've been doing well. You know, you're doing well. All of that, you know, would render you eligible to be part of the CYC movement and also to canvass within the Caribbean, you know, region. Wednesday afternoon, LH14. 3:05, we meet right there, okay? So be part of it, okay? And I'm sure it's gonna be a tremendous blessing to you. Okay, God bless you, everybody.
Guys, and the time is ticking and we are wrapping up. Now, guys, can we give a round of applause for all of our contestants here? They did an excellent job. I'm looking forward to seeing the judges are tallying. I'm looking forward to see who the winners are and the people's choice. Thank you for having me.
Good afternoon, everyone. As the judges tabulate, we just have a quick award ceremony to give. Last semester, the channel hosted a short story competition, and we'll be presenting the awards to the top three winners today.
Yes, so in third place, we have Julissa Thomas with a short story titled Overcoming My Brain. Unfortunately, she is not in campus as of this moment, so we will make arrangements for her to get the present to her. In second place, we have Kyra Richens with their story entitled Resilience. Is Kyra in the... Is anybody with us right now? No? Okay. Well, we're moving on to our first place, Monique Lively, with her story, His Story Is Complete, My Story Begins. Yeah, By the way, all of these were all the participants did receive. We did buy jerseys from them, courtesy of the USC bookstore, and all submissions were marked by the School of Education and Humanities. So shout out to them.
All right, so we're just awaiting the tabulations from the judges. Need I remind you of the judges? They are in the forms of Mr. Hayden McKenna, Mr. Vianney Tony, and Mr. Dominic Merritt. So just give them a round of applause as they tabulate the scores as we await our winner. We'll also receive the tabulated results from the People's Choice Awards. Did you guys get your votes in? All right. So as we await that information, we'll be scintillated by some music. DJ, run the track. Okay, so by way of information, USC Speaks has its registration open for individuals who would like to join the club. Feel free to contact Ms. Christina Lamesh or Mr. Will and Ivan Nurse, the president, if you'd like to join the USC Speaks, which is a spoken word club. So if you guys would like to get your poetry on, feel free to join USC Speaks and develop and nurture your talent. Whether it's hidden, unborn, just know that it can be developed. So feel free to contact Mr. Willan Ivan Nurse. Can you stand? Just let him see who Mr. Willan is. So you guys can check him, or Ms. Christina Lamesh. That's the vice president for USC Speaks. So that is all for now, until the judges are ready. Thank you. You guys ready for the information that I have here for you? You guys know who won the People's Choice Award? Guess who won? Shout out to you think got this one. Shout out. Make some noise. Let me hear you. I'm hearing an Alphesia. I'm hearing. Huh? Trim. All right. So I'll allow you to count down. I'm going to try this count down thing, right? It's a catchy something. So we're going to count down from 5. You guys count down. 4, 3, 2, 1. On whenever you guys are ready to start. And I'll give you the winner of the People's Choice Award. Now, man. Better than that, man. Come on.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Yeah, no, yeah, it's a zero. Start over. All right, so make some noise for the People's Choice Awards winner, none other than Ms. Zion Edwards. Give her a round of applause. The votes were in, and the votes came to Zion Edwards. Come on up, Zion. Receive your prize. The people chose you. We'll have the vice president of the Associated Student Body awarding her prize. So Good. So, come, let me get a picture too, please.
Make some noise again, make some noise. Good. Thank you very much.
All right. All right, so the judges are done. The scores are in my hands, and I hope I don't make a mistake like Steve Harvey and call the wrong thing. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll give everybody the opportunity to receive their participant certificate, and then we're gonna award the winner. So, in random order, calling the participants to receive the participant certificate, I'll ask for, I said in random order, but I'll call from the list. I'll call Ms. Zion Edwards to receive her certificate. Make some noise for Zion as she comes to the front, followed by Brother Daniel Anthony. And let's get Brother Joseph Trim up to receive his participant certificate. Good. Mr. Ashanti Prescott. Brother Will and Ivan Nurse. Brother Christian Beshu. Mr. Beshu. Miss Alfisha and Miss Cadence, along with Miss Gracie Samsundar. So make some noise as they make their way up. You guys gotta keep clapping, man. Let me see you guys' energy done. Miss Cadence Grant. Okay, lovely, lovely, lovely. Good. Smile, man. Yeah, guys, smile, oh man. Once again, I encourage you guys to check out usc.edu/vote ASB to get your nominations in, nominations close on March the 2nd, that is Thursday, so you guys can get your nominations in. Again, we thank each and every one of you for being out here today. I know you guys are anticipating the outcome of the results. The judges would have done an exceptional job in tabulating the information. It is very much a cumbersome task to decide and decipher and discern through all of the skill and talent you guys would have witnessed a winner for this afternoon. However, might I just say that everyone, each and every one of you participants are winners. You guys came out amidst the circumstances. You guys overcame your fears, put aside all of the nervousness, and you guys did your best. So we thank you for participating, and I'll be issuing the results at this time. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the information here is for your knowledge. I will go from the descending order coming up. And I'll start. There are awards for the first, second, and third place winners. And I'll begin from the third place individual. So the individual taking the third place prize is none other than Make Some Noise for Mr. Joseph Trim. Make some noise as he makes his way to receive his award. I know you guys are in high anticipation. Some folks were nervous. Folks were getting jittery there. However, the results are in, and Mr. Joseph Trin would have capped the third prize. And on to our second prize winner. This individual persevered through all of the obstacles that would have been presented to him. And our second place winner is none other than Make Some Noise for Mr. Christian Bashu. This guy is gonna scold me when I leave here. Make some noise as we get our first place contestant. Let me see what you guys, who you guys thought got this one? Oh, Alfisha. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for your first place winner for the Mic Check 2023 Poetry Competition. Make some noise for none other than Miss Alfisha. So there you have it. Our first place winner taking this year's first prize, Miss Alfisha Gershan. Make some noise. And by the way of information, each of our participants will be receiving prizes. So each of them will be receiving individual tokens. The first five participants, based on the order here, tabulated by the judges, will also be receiving a special token. So thank you all for coming out this afternoon, as we would have supported the Mic Check 2023 Poetry Competition. It was nice having you, and may God continue to richly bless you. Judges, we thank you very much for your participation and an insight in this afternoon's activity. It would have not have been possible without you. You guys had a very hard job, but you did your best. Thank you again. So the first participants, just remain there, let me